Hi, my name is Jesse. I'm a meter tech for the power company Riviera Utilities. As a meter tech, I have three main tasks. One being a meter reader. We have handheld devices that you'll put in your truck, and they're drive-by devices. So you'll ride from house to house as your handheld picks up the meters. And on an average day in our area, we'll read up to 25 to 3,000 meters a day. And the handhelds are, you can read up to 100, 150 meters in a minute or two. So it's very fast and a lot more fast paced than what it used to be back in the day. The second part of my job is going and collecting on delinquent accounts. In other words, we'll actually go up, knock on the door, and try to work out a payment arrangement for them. And if we can't arrange something where they can make a payment, worst case scenario, we'll have to turn the power off. And the third part of our job is we have sets and removals of meters, which is, say someone's moving into a house, then we'll go up and actually set a meter so that they have power into the house. And if someone's moving out of a house, then we actually have to physically go remove the meter so there's no longer power to the house. This is a 40-hour week job. Stress level is really not high, unless you're collecting from an upset customer. Things necessary for this job, you'd want to have a high school diploma, a valid driver's license, and it's not necessarily, but it'd be helpful to have an electrical background, and to have good people skills, because you're not always working with happy customers. A few things I like about the job is it's 7 to 3:30, 5 days a week, and you're outside 90-95% of the time, so you're not stuck at a desk all day. And a lot of people think that the worst part is collecting from customers when they haven't paid their bill, but you can actually help them in many ways. There's always people that they can go get help. There's organizations everywhere that'll help them with their bill to keep their power on, and we like to refer them to them people, for those organizations, because you don't want to turn somebody's power off, that, you know, especially they have kids and stuff like that. So in a way, it actually feels good when you get to help somebody, not always being the bad guy. And for any advice I'd like to give to become a meter tech, any kind of summer job that you could get, helping an electrician, anything of that sort, whether it's a tech school after high school would help you get this job, anything of that sort. Good social skills, good public appearance, and a good positive attitude will always help. And another thing that you may want to know, a lot of companies these days, they have policies against visible tattoos or outrageous piercings.